Welcome to the Soulish Podcast, and thank you for being here. My name is Whitney Apke, and I am your host. On the Soulish Podcast, we're talking all about the aha moments, the uncomfortable and painful lessons of life, how to deeply connect with ourselves and others, and the breakthroughs, big or small, that we experience in our body, soul, and spirit. We'll dive deep, and I'm so excited to share my experiences and thoughts, as well as bring on guests who are thought leaders and truth seekers. It's my desire to uplift, encourage, and inspire you in each episode. Today's episode is about the new year and our new vision and how to have more inner freedom and manifest our dreams and goals. Let's dive in. Well, happy new year and happy 2021 to you all. I'm so excited for this new year and just the opportunity to leave 2020 behind and to step into something new is always awesome and a great feeling. But I know for some of us, there's kind of this feeling of anxiety and it feels a little daunting and it's hard to not anticipate the worst when 2020 was so difficult and went so wrong for so many of us. And so here I am very excited, but I know that there's the opposite of that for a lot of you. And so I thought for this episode that we would chat a little bit about the new year and how do you narrow things down? How do you even see the positive, the grandiose vision for your life, the overall vision, especially when so many things were planned in 2020 and didn't happen? And is that possible for you to even have that vision or desires for 2021? Can you carry that vision into the next year? And what that looks like. And I know that there's a lot of disappointment. There's been a lot of letdown. And so I really want to encourage you guys in this first episode of the new year that we can dream again and we can set goals and we can achieve them even though we were maybe let down or disappointed previously. We have to keep going. And why do we have to keep going? I think we have to keep going because it's part of our makeup. As human beings, we are made to survive. We're made to not just survive, but then to thrive. And then we're not only made to thrive, but to have a vision, to have a future, and to look forward to something, and to want to build something. We are not the type of being that just sits back and gives up. And nature just isn't that way. You know, there's so many animals that end up losing their homes as well, whether that's from a fire or just another animal destroying their home or maybe a human being. They don't just like lay down and take it and give up. They don't give up. They actually go find a new place and they work hard to make a life and to survive and to sustain life and to enjoy their life the best that they can, right? And so if nature, animals can do that, how much more are we designed to overcome and to survive, thrive, and to anticipate the best and to work towards the best for ourselves and for our life? We have that built into our nature, built into our gut. We're 3D, you know, we have spirit, souls, and bodies. And so we're designed on all levels to keep going and to not give up. And so I first want to start with this episode and with this new year of saying to you that you are worthy of a vision or a dream or a goal. And if you can see it, then you can have it. And I know that that may seem very shallow or may seem very lofty and like, okay, Whitney, you know, sure. But you have to come to this core belief. You have to meet yourself here. And any parts of you that feel unworthy or not good enough or like you've been skipped over and the universe has just forgotten about you, you have to come to this place again. You have to meet yourself here and reconcile all parts of yourself to this one core truth. It's not even just a belief, it's a truth that you are worthy. You are worthy of having a vision for your life. You're worthy of having a dream or a goal. And this is something that I've struggled with my whole life. So I'm coming to you, coming from this place of, I have struggled with this for so long, for so many years, feeling like I keep pursuing this and I keep pursuing that. And I come up with a new vision, it seems, every year for my life, a new direction, a new goal, a new set of goals or dreams to attain. And what happens, you know? It falls apart or it doesn't happen. Again, another disappointment. So I feel you. If you are feeling that way and you're feeling like I have been disappointed over and over and over and over again, I just want to encourage you that you have to reconcile all parts of yourself to this truth, and you have to believe this truth in all parts of yourself. Your spirit, soul, and body has to feel this, that you are worthy of a vision. You are worthy of dreaming dreams for yourself, for your life. You're worthy of setting goals and working your ass off to get them. You are able to see what is going to happen in your future. Everyone has the ability to see, to have foresight. It's not just the ability of psychics and tarot readers. It's not just those people with the gift or they have an open third eye. Everyone is built with the third eye. Everyone is built with the ability of foresight and to see. And just the fact that we can create, that we can imagine things, that's not just for when you're a kid. And so you don't want to waste your abilities and just chalk it up to, oh, I was a kid and I just, you know, imagined things. No, that's actually by default what you are born with. That is part of your inheritance, is to see your future, is to see and to dream and to imagine and to go big or go home. You know, that's what we are built with. And so I want you to come back to yourself and leave the disappointment, leave those experiences behind. Take the wisdom from them of what you did, maybe what was said or who you partnered up with, maybe a business deal that went bad or went south or went wrong. I want you to take the wisdom from that. And that's going to benefit you going on in your future. But the disappointment, the feeling like you lack something, that you're maybe not worthy or not good enough for that next opportunity that's in your future, that is not helpful. That is not going to help you to pull your future into your present. That's not going to help you manifest. That's not even going to help you imagine or create or dream to see what you have for your life. That's actually going to hinder you. It's like putting on a blindfold. And all the while, all of that you dream and hope for and wish for is right in front of you, but you don't know where to put your hands to grab a hold of it because you're blindfolded by disappointment and resentment. And so I know this firsthand because it's happened to me, people. I have been right there. And I had to make a choice. Now, when I made that choice, did everything just align and plop right into place? No, it's been hard work. And it's been multiple times of, okay, let's redo that. Let's try that again. And it's been a lot of that, of reworking things, of starting again, of trying this or trying that, and having a lot of trying to figure out what is it. Like, I know what I feel in my gut that I'm meant to do, but what is it? And finally, in 2020, I let go of, right when the pandemic hit really bad in March, I actually had a moment where I let go finally of the resentment towards the universe, God, source, and my unforgiveness of all the disappointment in my life. And I finally let go with that and just said, you know what? I just want to know where to start. I don't know necessarily what the end goal looks like what I ultimately will be doing, like when I'm 80, but I just want a starting point. And if you can help me with that starting point, I'd greatly appreciate it. And I just remained open and I just meditated, I journaled, I just started trying to reactivate my imagination, my creativity. And one day I was just kind of sitting, working on stuff, and it just dropped in me, podcast. At the beginning of every year, as an offering of gratitude to the universe for all that I have been blessed with, I donate to a charitable organization that's mission aligns with mine. And this year, I am donating to No Kid Goes Hungry. In 2018, over 38 million Americans lived in poverty, and an estimated 15 million of those were children. According to the USDA, before the coronavirus pandemic, more than 11 million children in the United States live in food insecure homes, which means that those households don't have enough food for every family member. Today, projections show that 18 million children could face hunger this year. If this also resonates with you, join me this year in donating to No Kid Goes Hungry. The link is in the show notes for your convenience, or go to nokidhungry.org. Even though you've had hurt and pain, rejection, disappointment, even though you've been told no a million times, those no's still lead you to where you want to be eventually. You just don't see it yet. Instead of having someone tell you what you should do, you should know and have that truth in you. Those shouldn't be things that people are telling you that you should dream about, or telling you that you should have a vision for or goals in your life. It should be that you sit with yourself and you see your most authentic, true nature, and you dream dreams for your life and pursue them, and have people around you that support you no matter what and are championing you the whole way through, even through the ups and downs. So from that vision that we get, that overall arching dream, what is it for you? It may be that you want to own your own business, that you want to travel the world, that you want to be a musician and an artist and work with tons of awesome artists as well and create amazing art, whether that be music or visual. And it may be so many different things. There's so many great, amazing visions, beautiful visions that you can have for your life. It's just a matter of you sitting with yourself and seeing what you want. And maybe that is also going back to your childhood and seeing, well, what were my dreams when I was young? What was it that I just was like, oh my gosh, that would be so awesome if I did that. And I want to do that now still. And that still resonates with you. That's also one way to reconnect with your vision if you've been super disappointed and let down. And from that vision that you have for your life, for your future, you want to make your goals and values and habits align with that overarching vision or dream. And sometimes all you need is to also visualize your lifestyle, like ultimately what you want to dream of having. Even if it's crazy and impossible and, you know, out there, you want to visualize your lifestyle. Like, what is your day-to-day life look like? And that's how you can have your goals and your values and your habits then align with that future lifestyle. That's one way to do it as well. And then what I like to do at the beginning of the year, and sometimes even on my birthday, I like to just kind of do a vision board. And for me, sometimes my vision board, it doesn't look like pictures cut out. Sometimes I just take a journal and I will just kind of free write all over the place. And sometimes it looks really crazy and disorganized, but ultimately I have like either something in the middle of that page, I'll write down what I want, right? It's always been my dream to help people and help people find inner freedom from their demons or the unforgiveness or resentment, from the trauma, the abuse, the bullying. Those people I want to help. So that way they can manifest their dreams instead of replaying the same loop that they've had since elementary school. That's my overarching life goal. And I don't care how it looks like of achieving that goal. I just know that's my goal. But everyone's different. So it's just how you work and what works for you. What inspires you? What keeps you going? A lot of people, it's writing it out. It's journaling or meditating and then journaling, or sitting in a meditation and opening yourself up to your future and what you could see for yourself. So everyone is different. There's a couple areas in your life that you can set goals that can help you to achieve whatever that vision or goal or dream is that you want to achieve in your whole life. And that is financial, career, even like what you do for fun, your health, your relationships, and the community. And those are all areas that you can set goals in. And I like to actually write those out when I do the journaling vision board kind of thing. I like to put those areas up in there somewhere so that that way I'm reminding myself of like, yes, I need to visualize what do I want for my finances, you know, the levels of abundance. What do I want for my career and for that to look like? What are the things that I want to pursue that may seem very lofty? Maybe that's starting my own business, right? Or multiple different businesses that I see kind of coming into one place. So that could be a career goal that I have, you know, or multiple career goals, multiple businesses that I would like to create. And that may not just be in 1 year, but that may be a couple years, right? And then what I want to do in my leisure time, the things that I want to read, the places I want to go, the traveling that I want to do, the places I want to see, the people I want to meet. And then health, what are my health goals? What do I want my body to feel like, you know, and what sits right with me? And that's ethically, that's also sustainably for Earth. And so there's a lot of different things, but also I want to have better morning rituals and a better exercise routine and more variances. And so there's a lot of things that I'm looking at for my health personally. And that's a great area for you to also look at and assess, you know, what do you want for your health? And what are some things that maybe you feel like maybe you want to be more sustainable, and even just what you buy, just having nothing in plastic, but buying in bulk in glass or, you know, like the silicone baggies or cloth, you know, how do you want your health and like what you buy and that kind of sustainability and health and all of that? And relationships and like your community and what your relationship goals are, where you want to go in this next year in your relationship, if you have one. And if you don't have one, what kind of relationships do you want to have in your life? Do you want to remain single? Do you want to just be surrounded by certain people and certain friendships? Maybe it's the friendships that you have in your life that maybe you need to do a little house cleaning in that sense. Maybe not everybody has your back and is fully supporting you. So could be different things like that. Also the community that you live in or the community that is surrounding you, maybe even on social media, and cleaning that up as well. So it's all about how you're achieving your goals and what has held you back in the past and letting that go and pursuing the new things, the new ways, the new people that you want in your life that can help you achieve your goals. And so there's a couple ways to achieve your goals. And Forbes actually has a great article by Molly Kane about the 6 ways to achieve any goal, and I'll link it in the show notes for you. The 6 ways that she says is to look at it. Always see it. See how powerful your goal is and how it's going to impact your life, maybe the people around you, and tell people about your goals. That way, when you share it, there's some accountability there. And maybe also you need to break up your goal. Because a lot of people, she says, abandon their goals when it's just too big. So sometimes breaking down your goals to littler goals in order to achieve the bigger overarching goal that you have will help you have milestones as well. Another way to achieve your goal is to set a date. And that is a really great way to kind of hold yourself accountable as well. And it's very motivating. Another way to achieve your goal is to also be realistic and to know that you're human and you may not achieve every little thing in the expectation that you have, but you're at least making progress and you're at least headed in that direction and you're keeping your goal in your line of sight and not giving up on it. And the last way is to commit to yourself, because ultimately having a vision for your life is committing to yourself, and not in a selfish way, but in a very self-loving way, that you want your life to mean something and you want to do something meaningful with your life. And you know that you have a purpose and you know that you're worthy of that purpose. You're worthy of that vision, that dream, that goal. And so you're dedicating and committing yourself, your life, your thoughts, your feelings, your vision towards achieving that dream and keeping that in sight and not letting anything or anyone tell you differently that you are maybe not worthy or can't ever do something. And so I love that Forbes article. I'll definitely link that in the show notes for you so you guys can enjoy that and keep that also as you do your vision board and dreaming and all of that. I just quickly want to share with you guys the vision for this podcast for this year. I really want to take this podcast to the next level. And what that means is that I want to be a resource. I want this podcast to be a resource for you and for your life. The vision for 2021 is going through our inner freedom and how to gain inner freedom and all the ways that we have blockages or hindrances that keep us back from having and experiencing inner freedom. And then the second half of the year, I really want to talk about manifesting and getting into that. How do we manifest our dreams and our goals? And it may not flow exactly like half and half. There may be a lot of ebb and flowing. But that is the overall goal of what I want to work with you guys on this year. And so I really want this to be a resource to you that you can go through and almost kind of like each episode is a guided meditation, but like a guided talking meditation, and that it helps you reevaluate and sit and ask yourself the hard questions and make sure that everything is in alignment and feels right for you, is true to you. And so that is my overarching goal. And I hope that you enjoy every episode. And I would love to hear your feedback and any thoughts that you have that you would want to share with me, any of your stories. I love hearing your stories. I love connecting with you guys. And so I would love to know if you have an idea for an episode or a topic that you're struggling with that you would like for me to dive into. I would love to hear about that. So definitely reach out to me. Thank you so much for listening. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. The Soulish Podcast is not only a podcast, but a community where we can relate to each other and support each other in our soul journeys. Join the community on Instagram and Facebook at I Am Soulish.